Chromatic aberration may not be a term that you've heard before, but you've definitely seen it many times. You know how a 3D movie looks when you're not wearing the funny glasses? The video and the images have like a funny glow around them, kind of like the colors in the picture are being separated. Well, there's a reason for that, and today with the help of Filmora, who's sponsoring this video, I'll show you how to create this effect, why it's important, and how to use it to enhance the effects that you're already using. That's better. Stick around, I'll show you how.
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
The easiest way to understand what chromatic aberration is just that the different colors of light tend to propagate at different speeds. And they have different wavelengths, and so they tend to refract differently, especially through certain lenses. You've probably seen this anytime light has gone through a crystal and you get kind of a rainbow effect. But I'm not a scientist, I'm just here to show you how to do this effect in Filmora. Let's take an image and bring it down into our timeline. Now this is a real straightforward black and white image. If we want to create this chromatic aberration, what we want to do is stack four versions of this same image on top of each other. Now I've created some chromatic LUTs that I'm going to let you download for free so you can create the same effect. The very first track we're going to leave just as it is. The second track above that, let's add a new LUT. We'll put my green LUT there. On the track above that, let's add the blue LUT. And on the track above that, we'll add the red. Now the trick here is we want to change the way that these tracks are mixed together or composited together. So starting with this red track, let's go up to the image tab and let's open up the compositing tab in the dropdown. Instead of normal, let's switch that to lighten and let's dial it back to about 75%. Let's do the same with the blue track. And let's do the same with the green track. What's really cool here, let me turn off the bottom track. Here's just the green track. Now we'll add the blue track and now the red. Do you see how it goes right back to black and white? All of those colors are perfectly balanced to make up a nice white light. Let's turn our bottom track back on. Now we're gonna lock the main track and the green track. Most of the color wavelengths that our eyes quickly break down and see are the green, red, and blue. And it's the blue and the red that we tend to see shift most often. People use this to make 3D movies all the time or make digital images look more real, like in a video game where you're trying to make it feel more realistic as if it's being filmed by an actual camera and lens. What you want to do is let's click on that blue track, which will highlight up in your upper right in the preview window. And using your keyboard, let's use the right arrow to send that to the right, maybe 6 frames. Then let's click on the red track above that. It'll highlight the red, and let's move that in the opposite direction to the left for about 6 frames. Can you see what's happening to this image here? Suddenly it starts really coming to life with this chromatic aberration effect applied to it. I actually applied this exact same technique onto this clip of two planets colliding, and when they hit, I added some chromatic aberration and motion, and it really made it feel like everything was going crazy. Take this trick and try it yourself and see what you can come up with. Let me know how it works out. I'll put links down below where you can download these chromatic LUTs. And if you want to learn more Filmora tips, tricks, and techniques, be sure to click on the video on screen now or the ones I've got pinned down below. Peace.